fam, welcome back to our channel. This is Miss E, your Classy Beauty Savvy, and today I'm going to share with you my bullet journal 2021. So this is the old journal I've been using, so 1 year ko na tong gamit. And if you haven't seen this one yet, I'll be linking it up in the iCard above. I have done a bullet journal setup noong 2020 or this year, so dahil hindi pa to ubos, I'm going to use it. As you can see, hindi na siya ganun kalinis. This is the brand that I use, and yes, if you want to see how I set it up, please subscribe and let's begin. Right, there we go. This is how it looks pag binuksan natin siya, and I just put all of my cards here. Some membership card, my license card, ayan. And as you can see, medyo may dumi na siya kasi sinulatan siya nung pamakin ko. But yan, ito yung dati nating calendar for 2020. And let's see how the 2021 looks. Are you ready? So ito na siya! Yay! So as you can see, more than half lang yung nagamit ko dito sa bullet journal na to last year. That's why I'm repurposing it, using it for this year. And ito yung napili nating quote for this year. So it's actually a Bible verse. And it says, "Many are the plans in the mind of a man, but it is the purpose of the Lord that he will stand." So Proverbs 19:21. There! So, yan siya, and it's a sticker. I just got some stickers and a mini sew paper clip. And so, this is how the cover looks. Let's take a look at the overview or the calendar for 2021. So, I'm a sticker and a paper planner kind of, you know, person. So, meron tayong mga stickers, combination siya ng mga markers, and some drawings. And yan, if you see in the calendar, I've already marked down yung mga ano natin, paydays. This planner is actually for my financial planner. So, ito yung gagamitin natin for everything that I have to track when it comes to money. So, kaya if you can see the sa calendar natin, yun lang yung mga nakamark, yung mga paydays ko. So, yan. That's it. And then at the next page, we have special days. So, I have this flag here to take note of it and just to design it. And then I'm using like itong mga ombre label stickers na may heart. And if you notice, the colors are muted and just browns kasi gusto ko yon. And we also have the goals on the other side. We have financial goals, career goals, and personal goals. I'll be writing down all of my goals later on para sa 2021. There. And on the next page, you can see here the membership and subscription tracker. I got this idea from the Budget Mom. I'll be linking her down below. Most of the tools or trackers that I'll be using are from the Budget Mom. Yung ideas niya, I really like it. So we have the annual budget, and then the legend here, I have 3 sources of income, and I'm claiming that next year, 2021, I'll get income from YouTube na din. So please support me, guys. So yan, kaya may tatlong boxes dito sa ating income totals tracker. Yan. And then over here, you can see the expense categories. So we have the fixed expenses like the house, the internet, the insurance. Kaya nilagay ko na dito yung mga amounts. And then we have the variable expenses. So we have the other parts below. We have grocery, miscellaneous, and online shops. So, you know, I like online shopping, so kailangan naka-budget din yun sa ating planner. And I'm just covering some very confidential things sa planner. That's why may mga ganito tayong makikita. Showing you right now my 2020 annual budget. So you can see there yung mga bills na binabayaran ko. Na ito na yung setup natin for this 2021. Next up, we have the yearly balance overview. Again, from the Budget Mom idea. Ito yung mayroon tayong emergency fund na tracker. So we can see how well we're doing with the emergency fund. We also have the sinking fund tracker. Actually, this year, I will be starting again with my sinking fund. So mayroon tayong 9 sinking funds. We have the Christmas, vacation, birthdays, business, YouTube, self-care, fashion, food, and and medical sinking funds. And if you take a look at the other column, dito ko nilagay yung kung saan ko sila kukunin. So we have from the incentives, from YouTube, from Pru Life, and from my allowances. So dun ko kukunin yung mga ilalagay nating pera dito sa ating sinking funds. And I'm going to track it down from January to December. Yeah, and that's why we have this grid here. And then savings fund, we also have to take note of our surplus, yung pera na hindi natin magagamit will be allocated for saving funds. We also have notes areas, yan, meron tayong mga empty pages para sa notes in case na meron pa akong idagdag, at least may space pa tayo for that. And then on the next page, we have the bill tracker, and you can see here divided into two, the first payday and the second payday, and kung ano yung mga binabayaran ko for that specific payday. So, naka-tracker din siya, and yan, ilalagay ko lang yun. Kokoloran ko yung per grid niya once I have already paid for it. Yan. So, yun sa ating bill tracker there. And of course, on the other side, as you can see, it's another empty space for any notes that I would like to write. Ayan. So, ngayon, nandito na tayo sa January spreadsheet. Ito yung ating monthly, like, overview. So, you can see here, I view some stickers as well. I already marked down yung mga, marked again, our paydays and bills. Like, yung mga araw na babayaran ko yung mga bills. And I also use some color, you know, coding for that. And some holidays that I know. Okay, see, dito naman sa next page, we have the payday breakdown. So we have two pages for that, for the two paydays, or two paydays that I have for the month. So I have here the total income, the expenses, savings, yeah, so I'm tracking it down then. And again, I'm expecting three sources of income for 2021. So tinakpan ko lang again yung iba pang mga confidential things, pero tatlo sila. So meron tayong tatlong boxes there, and then other expenses, we have there again the fixed and the variable income. So yung first three, lagi silang yung fixed, and then the variable income, including the sinking funds. Now, eto na tayo sa ating monthly expenses tracker. So, as you can see here, ito yung isa sa mga favorite kong page kasi colorful siya. And I'm just going to show you over here yung aking 2020 monthly expense tracker. So, again, covering some details here. Sorry. Pero ayan siya. Ito yung mga example ng mga naisulat kong expenses last year. So, ayan. I'll be doing something like this again for 2021 para mas keep track ko yung aking mga expenses and mas ma-close ko yung aking budget. So, yan. So, that's what I'll be using this one for. And that's it, everyone. This is my 2021 bullet journal setup. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you learned something about it. And if you like the setup, let me know. Please send me a comment below, hit the like and subscribe button so that I can see you again next time. Bye, everyone.